Hey BC, it's Friday night and I'm chilling. I have been invited to several things tonight, which I probably am going to pass on all. I got my show tomorrow night and that's enough. It's Halloween weekend, so everything is costumes tonight and I'm really not into Halloween. Not really. So I'm going to respond to Anders' Circle of Musicians thread. Let me turn this down. Nice idea, and boy, you could go deep. Very, very nice how you did it. I don't have as many records on the circle I'm going to do. I did about 20. That was really very impressive and very, very, very cool. Very educational. That's the other word I've got to use, Anders. The connections. I got about a dozen records here. Nice idea, you know, and depending if someone else strikes me, I'll do another one. Right now what I'm listening to is Gigu Chenevier with Sophie Josserand, à l'abri des small climates. Chenevier came to my attention through being in the band Etrange Foulée de Blanc. It's just wild. Just again, sets up a different type of landscape. Okay, so the record that I chose to start with is, because I think I got it right, Hatfield and the North. We're going to start with this album and we're going to finish with it, okay? We're going to start with one person on the album and finish with another, okay? Hatfield and the North, just a fantastic Canterbury-based prog band. Members of Egg, Caravan, Robert White from Soft Machine is on here. Barbara Gaskin from Spirogyra is on here. But the person that I'm going to make the connection to is Jeff Lay from Henry Cow. He plays saxes and flute on here. Now, I don't know if I can get this to Jeff Lay. Henry Cow, saxes and flute. So that's where we're starting, okay? Remember, we're going to come back to Hatfield in the North is the last album. So Jeff Lay is on Hatfield in the North. He's also on the first couple of Henry Cow albums, and so I chose this one to show, Henry Cow. Let's see, Jeff Lay is right at the top of the list of musicians, as a matter of fact. Fred Frith is also on here. I could have gone that way, but I decided to go with John Greaves, the bass player. John Greaves was the original bass player for the band. Henry Cowell Leastways, he was the first one to record with them. So we're going from John Greaves here to John Greaves here, a solo album a collaboration album he made called Q Roan. And he made the album John Greaves with Peter Blegvad and Lisa Herman. Peter Blegvad first came to my attention as a member of the band Slap Happy that made an album with Faust. And that's the name I'm going with. So John Greaves from Henry Cow made this wonderful album. It's on Virgin too. What year is this? This is kind of Henry Cow-esque. It's wonderful. 1977. You know, it's close to jazz too. So we have John Greaves to Peter Blegvad. I chose Peter Blegvad's solo album, The Naked Shakespeare. Peter Blegvad is a very interesting songwriter and wordsmith. He's someone who is into words, and I can't quote anything here, but I have noticed how he writes. And for those of you that are interested in words, and good writing. Peter Blegbed is someone you might want to check out. This album was produced by Andy Partridge. Is that it? Yep. Andy Partridge, as you know, was the lead person in the band XTC, as well as the Dukes of Stratosphere. So I chose white music. I used to have an original where white music, you could see it across the top. This is a reissue. But this is a great debut album by a band. Every song on this album, really, I would say this is a 10. Okay, yeah, there's a 10 for you, Cosmic Rider. The first XTC is a 10. It was also engineered and produced by John Leckie. John Leckie has done a lot of stuff all the way up to modern times. Everyone from, you name it, including Muse and the Stone Roses and everyone, you know, all the way back through the Doves. And so the connection that I chose from John Leckie is Bebop Deluxe. He's just produced about everybody. But John Leckie produced this album, Sunburst Finish by Bebop Deluxe. Love this album. Drastic Plastic and this are my two favorite Bebop Deluxe albums. Love that cover too. And just so you can see the name. Produced by Bill Nelson and John Leckie. Can't really see it too well, but produced by Bill Nelson and John Leckie, okay? So that's the next connection. Bebop Deluxe was put together by guitarist, songwriter Bill Nelson, who has done a lot of stuff. Someone who the music business did him so wrong, it ruined his health. Read a long interview with him recently online, and he just got screwed by EMI and his publishers. You know, he could never get paid, you know, and it ruined his health and his marriage. It did. He's just one among many. But anyway, okay, so John Leckie from XTC to Bebop Deluxe. Bebop Deluxe, I'm taking John Leckie into Bill Nelson. Bill Nelson, the main guy right there. Bill Nelson is a guest guitar player on YMO, one of my favorite bands. I just love this band. Naughty Boys is the name of the album. And Bill Nelson plays guitar on this. Once again, I can try to show you. Just like people who like real commercial music and they don't need to explain or justify their taste. Same here. I just love YMO. Here's the inner sleeve. Can I find Bill Nelson's name in English? So far, no, but Bill Nelson is definitely on here. I know this because I have the CD, and the CD does have the, there it is. Yep, there it is, okay, on the back as well. Okay, I found it. Sorry, I'm using so much time on this one particular record, but just like Anders showed, he showed you where the name is. Bill Nelson is right there under the produced by and guitar played by Bill Nelson. And so we go from Bill Nelson to the star of YMO. Now, YMO was started by this guy over here, Haruomi Hosono. But the person that became the star of the band is the guy in the middle, Ryuichi Sakamoto. Interestingly, the two other guys in YMO precede Sakamoto as far as rock history. Hosono being one of the oldest rock stars in Japan, Takahashi being one of the first Japanese rockers to come to Britain as part of the new wave and post-punk. He had the band Sadistic Mika Band that toured with Roxy Music. Anyway, I'm going to go with Sakamoto as the connection from here. So Sakamoto here. We're going to a Sakamoto solo album. I just love Ryuichi Sakamoto's writing, playing, his whole aesthetic. Badass. Sakamoto plays with some of the best musicians in history. And two of them are on this album. You can't possibly make out the names with my crappy camera. But Brian Wilson of the Beach Boys is on here. And Robert Wyatt, originally of Soft Machine, is also on here. And that's who I'm going to go with, is Robert Wyatt, okay? So Sakamoto to Robert Wyatt. Robert Wyatt sings backup vocals on a couple songs on here. We go to Robert Wyatt's solo album, Rock Bottom. This is just another 10, which I've mentioned already. Absolutely gold. And one of the, since Robert Wyatt made this album after he became paralyzed from the waist down, he had to have another person play the full drum kit. And the drummer on this album is Laurie Allen. Not a household name, but Laurie Allen has been on the scene, the Canterbury scene, from the get-go. Laurie Allen. Drums. That's who I'm going with from here. Sakamoto to Robert Wyatt. Robert Wyatt to Laurie Allen. Laurie Allen to Gong. Gong has had a lot of different players and drummers. I don't know that many people know who the drummer is on this album, but it's Laurie Allen. And his he's called Lawrence the Alien, doing drum box kicks and knocks on this album. Where is it at? Did I get it? Yeah. Lawrence the Alien, that's Laurie Allen. Okay. Okay, so we have Laurie Allen from Robert Wyatt into Gong. One of the guitar players that was with Gong, I'm going to go with an obvious one, is Steve Hillage. Okay. So we're going from Gong to Steve Hillage. Great guitarist. Here's his Live Herald album, double live. Really, really good. His second guitarist for this particular tour was a fella from France by the name of Christian Boule. Oh, I see Clive Bunker, originally from Jethro Tull, was the drummer here. Also, Colin Bass from Focus is the bass player on here. But Christian Boule is the other guitar player. Let's see if we can get that. I don't know if you can see Christian Boule, but he's there. That's who we're going to go with here. Christian Boule has a style similar to Steve Hillage. It's more influenced by Gong than Steve Hillage. Well, I don't know. Yeah, he kind of sounds a lot like Steve Hillage. So, Gong, Steve Hillage, Christian Boule. Here's a Christian Boule solo album. Photo Music. And this is highly recommended. This is in the realm of the Gong family type of sound, and Clear Light, because that's the connection. This is pretty cool, actually. You know, there's some goofy songs in here, but there's some very good instrumental workouts on here, too. So Christian Boule, one of the people on this album, is Cyril Verdoux, who produced the album. Cyril Verdoux or Cyril Verdoux? Cyril Verdoux. Realization, Cyril Verdoux. So we go from Christian Boule to Cyril Verdoux, who was the leader of this project, band, Clear Light. And this is the album Forever Blowing Bubbles. This is some cool stuff. On Virgin. 1975 is when this came out. So one of the guest musicians on here, among others, Gilbert Artman from Lard Free is on here, among others. But David Cross plays violin. And that's who we're going to go with. David Cross came to my attention first through joining King Crimson right about this time for this amazing album, Lark's Tongues in Aspic. And David Cross plays violin, as you can see very clearly there. This is just a monster album, period, but it's a monster prog album. An absolute 10, 20, 30, whatever. This is one that is worth studying. Seriously, this is an album to study and learn from. I believe it's Henry Rollins who has this tattooed. Is it on his back? So from here, I could have gone, of course, with Robert Fripp, but I decided to go from here with Bill Bruford, the drummer. Notice there's some parallels here with Anders, Jamie Muir, Music Improvisation Company. Whole lot of parallels here between these musicians and some that he showed. A lot of work they've done together. So I go with Bill Bruford, and I'm just about to wrap this up. So here's Bruford's first solo album, and the band that he put together for this includes some of my favorite musicians of all time, which includes Alan Holdsworth on guitar, Jeff Berlin on bass, Annette Peacock on vocals, and Dave Stewart on keyboards. Dave Stewart is just one of the finest musicians to come out of the Canterbury scene. One of the finest musicians to come out of England, period, in my opinion. And if anyone was the mastermind behind Hatfield in the North, it was Dave Stewart. And that is the full circle. Let's see if we can get his name. Richard Sinclair, Pip Pyle, Dave Stewart. So that's pretty cool, Anders. Love this cover too, Japanese pressing. Love this album and this cover. Anders, what a wonderful idea. I hope that some other folks take the time. I actually did, even though I didn't do one as long as yours. I had to take a little bit of time and actually study to put this together. It could have gone many different ways because the whole, I like your challenge, which was make it a circle. Bring it back to the first record. For a minute, I thought I absolutely had to bring it back to the first musician, which I could do as well. And I started to do it with Stomo Yamashita, actually. Great idea. I hope some more folks do this.